Hi, I'm Eric. I'm product manager for the EVA Volumetric Karl Fischer Titrator. Today, I will show you how to install the device in order to be ready for your first measurement.
We start with the installation of main unit and terminal. Take the main unit and place it on a solid, reliable table in a well-ventilated room or even better, a fume hood. Then lay it to the side. Put the terminal cable into the cable duct and turn it back onto its feet. Position the terminal in front of the titrator. On the cable, you will find a small arrow. This arrow must look upwards to be aligned with the terminal socket. Push it in and fasten it down. Fix the titrator with one hand and pull the cable back with the other hand. Connect the cable to the mainboard. Also here, make sure that the arrow points upwards before pushing it into the socket. Position the D-drive unit and D-pump KF solvent pump to the left of the main unit. There are magnets on all three components that fix them to each other. To connect them to the main unit, you need two Octobus or short ACT cables. One to connect the D-drive to the main unit and one to connect D-pump KF to the D-drive. Make sure to align the pins of the cables with the sockets before fastening them down. Fix the titration arm to the main unit and attach the gray rubber strap. Later on, we will use the strap to fix the sensor cable. Let's now prepare the drying tubes. These tubes are filled with a drying agent, the molecular sieves. The drying tubes filled with molecular sieves serve as a filter and protect our water-sensitive KF chemicals against humidity. Make sure that you close them tightly. Take the adapter plate and attach the black rubber seal. Move it into the titration arm and rotate it clockwise until it's fixed. Check the orientation of the adapter plate. The largest opening should point towards you. Swivel the arm out and attach the glass vessel by holding the adapter plate with one hand and turning the vessel in anti-clockwise. For the actual measurement afterwards, it's important that the whole titration cell is sealed against humidity. So make sure that the vessel is properly fastened and the sealing is tight. Add the magnetic stir bar to the vessel and close the opening with the M24 stopper. Also here, make sure that you close it properly. Assemble the sample injection adapter. Plug it into the foreseen opening. Tighten it down by pushing it and turning it clockwise at the same time. Add the protective sleeve of the sensor to the titration arm and plug the D-Sense M143 sensor into the NS14 opening of the adapter plate. Also here, close it tightly. Attach the drying tube to the back of the titration arm. Assemble the silicon tube connector and use it to connect the drying tube to the adapter plate of the KF cell. Take the sensor cable. Check if the arrow on the white part of the cable and the gray arrow on the sensor are aligned. Push it in and fix it by turning the gray nut clockwise. Connect the other end of the sensor cable to one of the sensor sockets on the device board. Make sure to align the red dots before pushing it in. Then fix the cable to the titration arm with the rubber strap. Let's continue with the waste bottle of the D-Pump KF. Put the flat seal down onto the bottle, put the adapter on top and fix it with the nut. Connect the drying tube to protect the system against humidity. Use one of the two long air tubes to connect the drying tube with the fitting on the back of the D-Pump KF. Assemble the solvent tube with the O-ring and the adapter. Bring it to the waste bottle. Screw it in halfway, push the tube down a little bit and then fix it by screwing it down completely. Assemble the other end of the solvent tube the same way as you did before. Make sure that the tube is pushed down to the bottom of the glass vessel before fixing it with the nut. Before we continue with the assembly of the solvent bottle, we need to make some space. Move the waste bottle to the back side of the instrument. The solvent bottle is assembled similarly to the waste bottle. However, from now on we are working with chemicals, so make sure that you additionally wear safety goggles and gloves. Connect the solvent tube to the solvent bottle. Screw it in halfway and push it down until it reaches the bottom of the bottle. Then fix it down. The other end of the solvent tube is not pushed down completely until it reaches the bottom of the vessel. Here we leave it on top. Move the solvent bottle to the back, so we have enough space for the assembly of the burette. Put the red rotary encoder into the burette housing and turn it slightly until it falls down. Take the glass cylinder and the piston into one hand each and carefully push the piston in while turning it slightly. Use the white centering ring to bring the piston into the right lateral position. The white lower edge of the piston must be aligned with the edge of the glass. Take the black cylinder adapter and carefully push it into the glass while turning it slightly. Then move the whole assembly into the housing. Align the cylinder adapter with the two encoder pins. Then close the burette by pushing and rotating the valve head onto the housing. Mount the flat seal and the burette parking station to the KF titrant bottle and protect it from humidity with the drying tube. Take the suction tube and screw it tightly onto the parking station. The other end is screwed into the left thread of the burette. Do the same with the dispensing tube. It's important that you fasten the two tubes properly. Elsewise, you may have problems with tightened leakages afterwards. Mount the burette onto the D-drive unit. Fix it with the gray wheel and connect the tube to the last free opening of the KF cell's adapter plate. We are finally approaching the end of our installation video. The last part missing is the power supply. Take the power cable, align it with the socket as indicated on the mainboard, and push it in to finish the installation.
The titrator is now installed and ready to be used. In the meantime, I've set up a metal Toledo balance and I've connected it directly to the titrator for a seamless weight transfer. We are now ready to measure. Thank you for watching.